Now, how to find out where, what is the borderline of chronological planning and psychological worrying? That's the next question. What is the border? Whether I am chronologically planning or psychologically worrying? Any borderline? Chronological planning will give you tremendous satisfaction. You can see in your own, in your work. If you fall in love with work, working gives you such a deep satisfaction. You feel fulfilled. I have seen some architects. They don't even want to get married. They don't even want to have issues. Young architects. I asked them why. He says, I am feeling so satisfied, so joyful in creating. I don't feel like going to relationships now. The person is so satisfied. If you are a creator, understand, only God can create, nobody else can create. If you are a creator, you are experiencing godliness for that moment in you. When you create, you experience godliness in you for that moment. Only God can create, nobody else can create. If you are creating, you are experiencing God in you for that time. That part of your life, you are experiencing God in you. If you are creator, be very clear, you are God. Unless the God's energy works through you, you cannot create. Unless you experience God's energy, you cannot create. Understand? I am not talking about big creation, even the normal thing. Your office planning, your house arrangements, anything, if you create, you are God. If you create, you are working with the divine energy. Except God, nobody can create other matter. If you are a creator, you are experiencing God for that moment. So creator will never feel depressed. Creating is the ultimate spiritual practice. Forget about that. That will never disturb you. That will give you tremendous satisfaction. How to find out whether you are psychologically worrying? If you are sucked, if you are drained, if you feel uncomfortable, that's the scale you can find out you are not chronologically planning, you are psychologically worrying. If you are chronologically planning, you will never feel tired. You will never feel disturbed. You will never feel sucked. You will never feel drained. If you are feeling sucked, if you are feeling drained, if you are feeling tired, you are psychologically worrying. This is the scale. Whether it gives you satisfaction, end of the day, whether it gives you satisfaction or depression, find out. At the end of the day, what you feel is only M. That is only scale through which you can find out whether you are worrying or planning. One more thing. For planning, just now understand this one example. If you continuously record your inner chattering, it will come at least 15-hour tape. Am I right? Because you are waking time and dream time. Both the time, inner chattering goes on. Only in the deep sleep, there is no inner chattering. You are in three states. Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti. Jagrat and Swapna, both, there is a continuous inner chattering. Only Sushupti, don't have inner chattering. So average at least 15 hours per day, the tape will work. In that 15-hour tape, visualize it's a 15-kilometer tape. If you actually plan, you don't need more than 2-3 kilometer tape, because you are not going to plan more than that. Even 2-3 kilometer is too much, according to me. How much we create for our creation or our kind of lifestyle, you don't need more than 1 hour or 2 hour in a final chatting for your chronological planning. Then what you do with other 13 hours? What do you do other 13 hours? So the best method to stop worrying is start creating. Start creating. Become an artist, become a poet, become a painter. Don't bother whether your paintings are sold or not. Don't bother, don't start worrying about exhibition, how to make exhibition out of my painting. No. Don't bother about the effect or the result. Just start creating. You will see, you will live a tremendous satisfied life. To stop worrying, the first thing, start creating. If you are a housewife, start something. Garden. Some cooking. Some way, start creating. Start planning chronologically, continuously. That's the one beautiful technique. Empty mind is devil's workshop. When you don't have something to do, something to clearly plan, you start worrying. If you flow like a river, you will see a river, whenever river flows, it keeps itself clean and it cleans the people, comes near it. Whenever it becomes a pool, the pool also will be contaminated and people who come here also will be contaminated. So if your being is flowing like a river, continuously, some useful way, you will never feel worried. You always have an idea. If you have enough money, you don't need to work. If you stop working, devil will start working. Understand? If you stop working, devil will start working. Whether you want to work or he wants to work, you decide. Whether you should work or he should work, you decide. You always have an idea. Working is only for the sake of money. After money, what you want to do? You don't want to work, just sit and worry. If you sit, what else you will do? As on now, if you sit, you can't do anything else except worrying. That is why most of the people, they go for meditation, but when they come back, they have enough of worries. Because at the time of meditation, instead of meditating, they are all worrying, they are continuously sitting and worrying. I have seen the people when they meditate, they wear a long face. If you are having a long face in the meditation, be very clear, somewhere something is wrong. Somewhere something is wrong. Meditation is a love affair. You are excess, you are yourself. If there is no smile in your face at the time of meditation, be very clear, something is wrong somewhere. It means, instead of meditating, you are sitting and psychologically worrying. It's like you go for taking, the elephant goes for taking bath, but it takes all the mud and throws on itself and comes back. Your mental structure, your verbalization, some area gets corrupted and same thing repeats. That is what I call worrying. There's one more reason why so much of time is wasted in worrying. Because the root from where the inner chatting raises, the very root is corrupted and contaminated. The root is navel center. The whole city, the water supply for the whole city happens from a tank. Visualize, there is a tank from which the whole city is supplied. If the hot tank is poisoned, then what will happen? Whole city will have poisoned water. Same way, the Manipurva is the tank from which the inner chattering rises. If the Manipurva is corrupted, contaminated, poisoned, all your inner chattering will be filled with poisons. How Manipurva is corrupted? Too much of suppressions. Too much of repressions. Whenever you feel anger, violence, you just suppress it. For example, Your boss shouts at you for no reason in your office. You feel like I'm giving a good blow to him. But can you give? No. If you express, what will happen? Lose the job. If you express it in the office, you lose your job. If you express in the house, you lose your food. In both places, you cannot express. Then what will you do? Suppress. Continuously suppressing, suppressing. And now there's a doing research. And on thoughts. This Deepak Chopra, he did a beautiful research. He says, whenever you get angry, there's a chemical release in your body. Certain chemicals and toxins are released in your system. If you express your anger, then finish, no problem. The chemical leaves your body. If you suppress, the acid which is created creates acidity in you. What will happen to the suppressed acid? Where will it go? What will happen to the toxins? They will stay only in your system. He says it's almost like an acid bath. You are all floating in acid tub. Your being is floating in acid tub. Being is nothing but Manipura Chakra. Your being is floating in acid tub. So much of suppressions. That is why you bang your door. When you come back from the office, what do you do? Bang the door, throw the shoes. There's so much of suppression. Actually, now what we do? Boss vomits on you. You vomit on your wife. Wife goes and vomits on kids. Kids on servants. Servants on pet animals. Pet animal comes and bites you. That's a circuit. Goes on, goes on, goes on. Each one is unloading on somebody else. Each one is vomiting on somebody else. If you have the technique to vomit it on air, then whole thing will be solved. Now we are going to vomit on the air. On sky. Not on anybody else. Just we are going to throw away. We are going to fight with the air.